What are alpha lipoic acids benefits? Let's talk about that. So first of all, it's important to note alpha lipoic acid, or ALA as I'll refer to for the rest of this, it's naturally found in foods, particularly in organ meats like liver, heart, and kidney. So if you're eating those things, you probably don't need to supplement, but if you don't, supplementing may make some sense. Now, alpha lipoic acid is primarily known as an antioxidant. I don't think that's particularly fair, because while it can act as an antioxidant, it plays a role, it seems to be very rapidly metabolized, and we really don't know how strong that effect is. But what is strong is the fact that we know it's a cofactor in metabolic functions, meaning inside your mitochondria, which is very important for your energy production. ALA is required for some of those functions. So that's very important, and it's something we're going to talk about with these benefits. Now, I'm going to go through five major benefits. A few of them have good evidence. A couple of them don't yet, but it may be promising. So the first benefit I want to talk about is diabetic neuropathy. I've done a video on this, and I do think there's some promise there. In fact, in Germany, you can only get ALA by prescription in Germany, and they're kind of ahead of the game on some of these natural substances. It is approved there for diabetic neuropathy, but mainly the doses we've seen is anywhere from 600 to 1800 milligrams a day, and they did see some of those symptoms go down. Definitely not a cure-all, but does appear promising. The second benefit we want to talk about is it does appear to decrease cholesterol levels slightly. The two primary ones we've seen is a decrease in LDL and a decrease in total cholesterol. Again, not monster changes, but it is promising. And these were seen in certain populations, so it's not across the board for everybody. An interesting one is the third benefit that has some evidence behind it, which is weight loss, which will perk a lot of people's ears up. However, keep in mind, it did decrease it, but these were not big decreases. On average, we're looking at 1.5 to maybe 5 pounds of weight loss, and it can occur over different periods. The dosing they used in studies was 300 milligrams to 1800 milligrams a day. They used it for a wide range of durations, as short as 2 weeks to as long as almost a year at 48 weeks. And the studies were done in obese subjects, overweight subjects. The interesting point, the weight loss did not appear to be related to the dose or the duration, how long people were taking it. So that's kind of, to me, a promising thing. Now, a couple of other disease states I want to talk about. And could ALA potentially be a benefit? So these are very potential at this point, but the first one would be multiple sclerosis. They've done mouse studies, and those were promising. The human studies are ongoing, so we really don't have that information. So I would say a big maybe on MS. AD is Alzheimer's disease as the fifth potential benefit. Again, we don't have a lot of information on that, but one thing I want to point out, there's more and more research coming out with these two things. And based off my experience with folks, I do think there's a metabolic or a mitochondrial component to both multiple sclerosis and Alzheimer's disease. So I think it shows promise. That's something we want to keep an eye on. Certainly not proven at this point. And by the way, if you want to know, I have seen things benefit those two disease states. I talk about it on my email list. You can go to curtis-alexander.com, get your free checklist. I talk about those things much more there. Okay, there's a link in the description. Now, some important points about alpha lipoic acid, kind of wrapping this up. Number one, how much should you dose? Well, I've given you some examples. If you're looking at addressing a specific disease state, overall, if you don't eat organ meats, you may want to look at maybe 200 to 500 milligrams a day. The studies, again, were anywhere from 300 up to 1800 milligrams a day. It does appear to be tolerated pretty well. One thing you may want to do, and I've heard this from a number of different people, is you may want to cycle on it and off it. meaning some people will be on it long term and then they feel like the benefits go away, so they will hop off it for a bit, reintroduce it, and those benefits to them, at least the feedback I've gotten, there's no science behind this, appear to kind of come back. So something to think about. Again, we really want to focus on trying to increase particularly those organ meats to get this from a food source, but if you absolutely can't do it, supplementing is certainly an option. And speaking of the supplement, there is a lot of noise out there about our alpha lipoic acid, RALA versus SALA, and there's RS, and there's a mixture of these, and what should you take? At this point, I think the best option is to look for a liquid RALA. Now, some people feel like, oh, of course, you should always do RALA, but here's the thing. They've looked at studies where they've given RALA, and it did show better absorption. Okay, but the other thing is whether you take RALA or RS or just the S, they're all rapidly metabolized and they're eliminated rapidly. But if you had to pin me in a corner, I would say look for the RALA. Try to get it if you can in a liquid formulation. I'll try to find some products that I think are solid and put links of those in the description as well. Also, we believe that all this stuff, the absorption, the metabolism, the elimination is dependent on age and gender, so your mileage may vary with that. But at the end of the day, I would shoot for the RALA. So let me know in the comments, guys, if you've taken ALA, did it benefit anything? Did it not benefit anything? Anything that would be helpful to somebody else watching this video as far as your comments, I really appreciate it because I value anybody that's actually taken the product. Your feedback's really important to me on that. So, hope this video was helpful, you guys. I will see you in the next one. Thank you.